Hello everybody, this is Angie and I am here to do a review of my Tonic multi-sided lantern box and show you some samples that I made and just discuss it a little bit. But I love this set. I love making boxes and things. But I will try to open this up to show you the pieces. Now they're not completely situated correctly because I've been using them, but these are the pieces that you get. This is actually the basic of the lantern. If you want to make a four-sided box like this, you cut four and you could connect them together. Now you can make a five-sided box, and I'll show these in more depth later, and you make five of them and cut them together. And all of these little pieces for the sides and the top are interchangeable. You can make them into die cuts and put them on the box, or you can cut them into the box. And I hope I didn't completely confuse you, but I think my samples will help to show it a little bit better. When I said you could use the, and I'll go ahead and put my camera down, excuse me. I'm sorry if I'm jiggling the camera. But when you want to use, and it's exactly the same dies, to cut into the box, you can make a lantern, but and also you can make a decorative gift box. But that's cutting into the box. And this is using the dies to make the die cut to put it on top of the box. And you get quite a few different versions. This one is more Christmassy, of course, because they have the star and the candle in the middle. And this one just is a plain curve. And again, the candle, but I wanted to show you the two different tops that you have. See, this one has a lot more intricate curves and everything, and this one has that half round. That's what's so pretty about all the different pieces that you get, is that you can change them out. But of course, this is the four-sided box. And then you get the five-sided, which really gives you a very, very big box. And this is good for cookies and larger things or larger gifts that you want to make. Again, there's that more Christmassy cut with the candle and the star. And here are the ones with the curves. But you do close it only one way, so you don't have an option with that. I mean, if you wanted to tuck these sides in, you would have to do some trimming of this part right here, and then it would be permanent. They would have to tear open the box, because this does not have an opening the way it's made. And I hope I'm not confusing anybody, but it's really made to have this type of closure for the ribbon to be threaded through and then tied with a bow. But again, that's being cut into it, that's with the die cuts on top of it, and the different interchangeable die cuts that give you a totally different look. And that's what I love about the Tonic Studio dies, is that they are interchangeable. And just like right now, I have on the side, I have the gingerbread die set by Tonic, and just wanted to show you that you could take this window and put it on this box, and it would fit. Let's see if I can bring it up closer. And that's this window came from the gingerbread house set. And there's also this window with a frame that would fit onto the boxes. So you have all kinds of things that you could do with these dies, including, if you don't want to, if you want to make a card, you could use these different things to make a pretty little window on your card. But again, this is the gingerbread set. I'm sorry, I don't mean to mess you up, because what I'm talking about right now is the multi-sided lantern box. And both of these sets are by Tonic. I got them both off of Amazon, pretty decent price, and I got free shipping because I ordered other things for Christmas gifts. But I think that pretty much covers this die set. I really like it, and it's not difficult at all. It looks very, very intricate, but it's not. And, oh yeah, if you have any questions, please feel free to jot them down there. My name is Angie. I am Mary Scrapper 13 here on YouTube, and I am wishing you a wonderful creative day. Bye now.